Hello friends, this is Harish Nagar and in today's video I am going to talk about Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. Guys, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee was born in 1838 and he died in 1894. Now his novels were firmly established prose as a literary vehicle for the Bengali language. If you look at his works, you will find that he is the first person who started writing novels in India, and therefore prose was established by him as a literary vehicle. He also helped India to create a school of fiction based on the European models. He was a member of an Orthodox Brahmin family and he was educated at the University of Calcutta. So he was one of the first person to graduate from that particular college. So you can see how he become a founder of Indian literature, especially the Indian prose literature. Now guys, in this particular lecture, I shall be talking about three works by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, namely Rajamohan's Wives, a novel published in 1864. Now guys, this work was the first novel written in English by an Indian author. Make sure you remember this fact that it is the first novel written in English by an Indian author, and it appeared serially in a journal called Indian Field. Now this particular work did not gain much attention, and therefore he turned his attention away from English writing and he moved his attention to Bengali literature. So all other works written by him are written in Bengali, whereas this is the only work which he wrote in English. The story is very simple. The story revolves around the life of Matangani. She is the protagonist and wife of Rajmohan. Matangani was called the Rajmohan's wife because Matangani does not have her own identity. Her identity is only that she is Rajmohan's wife. So that kind of pain is depicted in the title. The story revolves around the Matangani, and we find that the work was written during the revolt of 1857. So we have a woman character as a protagonist, which is very interesting and revolutionary in itself, and we find how women were given subjugated position in Indian society. And for the first time you have a writer talking about the role of women in Indian culture. Plus, we also have a theme where they are showing that in Indian culture, women are the symbol of purity and a woman is not the property of Britishers. So we have Rajmohan's wife, which is a strong-willed woman. She transgresses all the social norms of the society by expressing her love for her brother-in-law, and she runs away from her husband to stand for what is right. The novel also mirrors the ills of the society, because if you look at the life of Matangani, you will find that she was married off in haste. Why? Because her family was suffering from financial problems, and therefore her father had no option but to marry her daughter. When she was married, she found out that her husband is ruthless and he beats her up for no reason. So Matangani's character embodies the idols of what Mother India symbolizes. So that was the main theme of Rajmohan's Wife. Now guys, the next work by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee is Kapal Kundala. This was published in 1866, and the heroine of the novel is important because the heroine is modeled partly after Kalidas Shakuntala and partly after Shakespeare Miranda. Finally, we move on to the last work, that is Anand Math. I am sure that even if you don't know about Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, you must have heard of this work, Anand Math. Anand Math was published in 1882, and Anand Math, when translated in English, means Abbey of Bliss. Now it is a political novel which depicts the Sanyasi army fighting against the British soldiers. So you can see the rise of Indian nationalism in this work. Then it is also based on the Sanyasi rebellion. What is this, the Sanyasi rebellion? Basically guys, Sanyasi rebellion means when there was a time when untrained Sanyasi soldiers were fighting and beating the highly experienced British army, and ultimately they found that Britisher cannot be defeated, and therefore they claimed that Britishers are not the enemy but they are the friends. The actual enemies are Muslims. So Muslims were treated as the actual enemy, whereas Britishers were treated as a friend. So you can see how every writer that we are going to look at will have their own notion towards what is real independence. For Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, real independence is not only getting freedom from Britishers, but also getting freedom from Muslims. Whereas we have writers like Rabindranath Tagore, we have a writer like Mahatma Gandhi, who said that we need to all live together. All the sects of people who are living in India, they are part of one nation. And therefore, we all need to love each other. If we have problems among our own nation, then anybody could take advantage of that, just like Britishers did. And the novel is also important because it is the source of the song Vande Mataram, which can be translated into English as I worship my motherland for she truly is my mother. And Vande Mataram was taken up by Rabindranath Tagore from Anand Math, and he takes it into music, and that became the national song of India. So the novel from which Vande Mataram is taken from is Anand Math, written by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. So in this particular lecture, we have looked at three works of Bankim Chandra Chatterjee: Rajmohan's Wife, published 1864, Kapal Kundala, published 1866, and Anand Math, published 1882. So that's it for today's lecture. Thank you.